Mother!
Well, it finally happened. Went home this weekend, and my mother found out I was atheist. She started asking me questions, and I had responses already ready up here. But the fact that she asks some of these questions, like, one of the questions was, so you don't consider life a miracle? Well, considering that I believe the definition of a miracle is something we don't already have the ability to explain, then no. We know how life comes about, and if she was referring to human life being a miracle, with how complex it is. You know, I've seen really complex animals. Humans always have this belief that they're the best animal out there. And it is true, we have evolved quite a lot. We've learned the use of tools, complex tools, that do put us above most animals. But the fact is, we are still animals. Our birth isn't much different than any other animal birth. So I asked her, do you consider the birth of a dog a miracle? She then promptly turned to my dog, who was there, and in a cutesy voice started going, oh yes, you are a miracle. Yes, you are. Better tell your brother that you're a miracle. Is it normal to treat someone with that much disrespect in the middle of a serious discussion about religion? Especially your own mother. To start ignoring you and talking to your dog about how that's a miracle. When I told her that I believed praying doesn't do anything, she said, quote, you blew my mind. Now it is true, for someone to believe in a religion for that long, for their own son to say, I don't believe you are right, can be shocking. But to believe that your thoughts can change things because a higher being hears your thoughts and says, oh, I like what that person's thinking. I'll answer their prayer. To think that's true is kind of ridiculous. And apparently, I blew her mind when I told her that I thought that was ridiculous. Now, what I thought was the most ridiculous part of this whole conversation was her proof for believing in a god. She had two main reasons for why she believed in a god. One night she was pretty tired, but she couldn't get to sleep. So she went downstairs and started doing taxes. She said this was about 3 in the morning. While she was working on her taxes, she claims to have been hearing angels singing. She looked around the house, couldn't find any radios on, TVs on, anything. And that's one reason she believes there is an afterlife and there is a god. Now, if she was doing this at 3 in the morning, while she was doing taxes, don't you think she might have fallen asleep and had a dream about that? Now, think about it. Taxes aren't the most interesting things to do in the world. They're pretty boring, and they can put you to sleep. Add the fact that it's 3 in the morning, and a person's bound to fall asleep. Her second reason for believing in a god happened shortly after she lost one of her best friends to leukemia. She believes that one night, again, at night, she saw her friend after she had died and carried on a conversation with her. And at the end of their conversation, they hugged. She says that that hug felt so real that it had to have been real. Again, happening late at night when you're having trouble sleeping. Obviously, something was on her mind, and obviously that thing was the loss of her dear friend. Now, I know when I go to sleep, with something nagging on my mind, sometimes I'll have dreams about it. And yes, I've had dreams that were so real and so vivid that even I've thought that they were true. That doesn't mean they were true. People can imagine strange things in their sleep. I know. The mind's a complex thing. Just because you saw your friend after they died, when it was late at night and you were already tired, doesn't mean that that person still lives on in the afterlife. Now, we did have several discussions about the topic of religion over the weekend, and she always kept bringing up questions that I thought were pretty basic. Where are you going to go when you die? I thought everyone knew they were going to go into the ground when they died. One question that she asked that really bugged me was she had asked me if I had been talking about other people about atheism. But the tone in her voice made it seem like she thought I had been brainwashed into not believing in a god. Now, I'm the one who went out thinking something doesn't make sense about religion. I went out and researched. I sought out the opinion of several different views. Not only Christianity, but in high school I took a world religions class. All these different religions, I looked into their views, into what they believed. None of them made sense. It took about a year and a half after that class for me to decide that there was no God. In that time, I guess you could have called me agnostic. I wanted to believe so much that there was a God. But everywhere I looked, nothing made sense. Just because you can't prove it doesn't exist, doesn't mean it does. And I came to that fact some time ago. But apparently, my mother will never come to that fact. This is going to be a tough time for me. Because I was raised in a rather Christian family. Now that she knows, probably the rest of my family will know. Including my aunt, who is so religious that she prohibits her children from playing Pokemon because she believes it teaches the evolution. I've got a tough time ahead of me, YouTube. Wish me luck. Mother, take it to-